come with some noise, some sound like, ooh, cheers, ganbei. So, and the host always the host is always the first person who give the toast. Who paid the bill? Usually the host pays the bills, and usually who want to close the deal, that person needs to pay the bill. And also, if for example, if my friends visit me in London, so I'm acting like a host in London, so I need to pay the bill. It's awkward for us to share 50-50. We don't do that. We usually either I pay for this time and you pay for next time, so we don't share on the table. For the gift, it's always good to give someone gifts when a holiday, a birthday, and meetings to nice gifts. So this is gift you should not give to the Chinese. Anything that's sharp, like scissor, or any number, and anything have number four on it, because four sounds unlucky in China. We don't like this number. Pier, that means separate in Chinese, so we don't like it either. Umbrella, especially red umbrella, that means that's the only thing for the ghost, so we don't like it. Clock, it also means something, someone gonna die. What do you call the flower?
Sunflower.
It's not sunflower. Yes. So that is also the flower we give to bad people. And the cup, any glass, any teapot, that means tragedy. And shoes, that means you send somebody away. So don't give them this. So this is me. Any question? Yeah.
How do you say that birthday of age 4 or 40?
How do you say that?
Can we send a card of the age 4 or 40?
I guess you can say happy birthday, but don't make emphasis to the number. And everyone got their birthday 4 years old, 14 years old. Yeah, you can still celebrate it. But I mean, if you give someone a gift, don't have the number 4 on it. That's not good.
Thank you, honestly. It's a good to know about the cultures, and we can learn always.
Yes.
How do you deal with Americans anyway? Because they are very pushy and very sales oriented.
Well, that depends on who wants to close the deal. Do they want us? Do they want to do business with us, or do we want to chase them? So if the Americans want to do business with us, so they have to change, So if on the other way, so we need to change, then probably we need to change our habits. So it depends on who got the most power, I think.
Really? Last question.
Ninhao. I was just wondering, I think a lot of fears with Western businesses operating in China is kind of the imposition or intrusion of the state. I think this past month has showed that quite clearly with the crackdown on cryptocurrency and things like that. So my question is more to the point that how acceptable is it in business terms and in social terms to sort of discuss the state and state policy?
State policy of China?
Yeah.
Is quite sensitive.
Yes.
Because we... How to say it? People think China is a safe country, but in my opinion, I just think that's because we are blocked. If any bad news happen, we just don't know. So Chinese government do control every aspect of our life. It's different to the nature here. So to talk about policy or anything related to state is quite sensitive. Even if we don't agree with something, we don't tend to share with other people because that is going to put us in a really dangerous place. if really serious situation, we may get into the jail. So this is quite sensitive. Yeah, try to avoid it. Try to talk about food.
One more thing. So how, like, child become 4 years old and 4 years not to be given? How do you say? Here is it. Today you are four, or you know, happy birthday, you are four. Skip four after 3 years, suddenly become 5 years.
Well, I mean, just like here, you get the unlucky number is 13. It's the same thing, right? But you still have 13th birthday. So how can you? But just because number four, the pronunciation of four in Mandarin, 四, that is similar to that, which is 四. Yeah,
that makes sense.
That is the. Yeah, I hope the sharing today is helpful.